Football Federation and require public expenditure in the National Football Federation's plan to build revenue before any further funding decision should be taken going forward. We further ask that the Ministry of Sport be less lenient when it comes to funding delinquent and underperforming organizations. We recommend that the Ministry establish an ordered, comprehensive, and stringent set of funding and support guidelines and incentive programs instead of the practice of bailout type activities. The Ministry of Sport must play a role in addressing the flawed league system in Trinidad and Tobago. This can be done primarily through closer integration of league structure and assisting clubs to secure small but adequate facilities that help offset funding costs. I'd just like a break from the presentation to remark on this last point. The previous speaker made mention about promotion and in particular funding. And it's interesting that the government has actually 150% rebate on people who fund sports, and yet still there are few corporate citizens taking advantage of it. So I encourage people to corporate citizens out there to get involved in that regard. Continuing, a national policy statement on football and a comprehensive executable plan for the short term, medium term, and long term should be crafted by a commission comprised of government officials, business people, and former athletes. I think something along the lines of a tripartite committee was once in place, and there were some good things that came out of it. I'm not sure exactly why it was eventually not as successful as it should have been, but I think it is something that we should include a greater emphasis on youth development, introducing youth to competitive football at an early age, and stopping the coaching merry-go-round that is creating a drain on the game. We must strengthen our existing systems and maximize our intellectual capital by utilizing the knowledge and expertise of both local and foreign-based coaches, administrators, and players. And last, we must be resolute in sticking to our plan and keeping our promises to fans, players, sponsors, and all stakeholders in football. Show your friends to show your agreement on that one. Thank you for the opportunity to express our views from the various members of WarriorNation.net. Now, from me personally, as a supporter and as a fan of Trinidad football, I'd just like to make a couple points. Listening this morning, the Minister mentioned being able to manage talented players, geniuses, and I want to agree with 100%. I do notice that in recent times, you can't seem to produce your celebrities and you don't have workers anymore. That kind of player with creativity and flair, you could change the dynamic of a game. And you know, these things are cyclical, so hopefully in the times to come, there's a young man in Mulan, I'm not sure what school he plays for, but I've seen some indications that he could be some up-and-coming player at that mold. I think he could be a member of the participating in Tony. And I just want to touch on something, but it's something that I feel very strongly about. Often when I'm calling programs, even in the media, this talk about local players and having a team of local players together, a la what occurred in 1989 when we were so successful. And to people who hold on to that, I want to say this is the year 2011, and something like that just cannot fly. I mean, if we look at one of the most successful football countries in the world, Brazil, I think everybody in this room would agree with me that there are far more talented players in Brazil, given the scope and just the ability and tradition over the years. And I don't think anybody in the right mind would say we only want players who play in the Brazilian league to represent Brazil. So if we're serious about going forward, let's put that suggestion to rest. We could see already from 2006, in one single time, we were able to participate successfully at a senior World Cup through qualification. I'm not typing out word, as in some cases we had new tournaments. When we were successful in that, what we did, we had a first-rate coach who had a history of success, participated in several World Cups, and he molded together a team comprised of the best local and foreign-based players. And I think if that model worked once, don't see why we should break